Alright, I feel good about this one, because I've already done the tonal value sketches, and I've simplified the illustrations to make it easy to translate into a little painting. You know, when I create thumbnails, I still do pencil underdrawings on the actual paper that I'm going to paint with, because they usually contain characters in them, and characters need to appear consistent. They need to appear with a specific shape, size, and proportion. So it's important for me to lay down the underdrawings to guide me. But in this exercise, since I'm only doing this to get me used to painting seascapes and water, I thought I would take a looser approach. And so I skipped the underdrawing and just went straight at it with a paintbrush. Anyway, it's not like I'm painting blind. I still have my thumbnails to refer to for the composition and the tonal values. Now, this is how I figured out that this approach would likely be the best approach for this exercise. When I was waiting for the paint pigments that I ordered, the paint that I would use for the book, I thought I would get started with some preliminary color studies using some old paint that I have. These ones, Nicker gouache paints. I ordered Holbein gouache paints because they come in bigger tubes. So while I was waiting for the Holbein paint, I used the Nicker gouache to test out which paper would be best to use for my book. It's the Nicker gouache that I used for this bristleboard paper that I was testing initially. I created a pencil line art underdrawing for them, and I had a photo reference to help me determine the colors. But I didn't do any tonal value sketches, so the outcome wasn't so good. This green shape here that's crawling up the cliff, that looks like a tree, that's supposed to be a shadow. So I messed up the tones here, and I thought I'd make up for it over here, which came out just a tiny bit better, but it was still not looking the way I was intending for it to look. So I repeated the process and I drew the same set of sketches on another sheet of paper. This is the mixed media paper. And I had the same set of photo references. And so the outcome was actually not much different. The colors still look quite confused, and the tones are still quite dark. There's not enough contrast in them. And so at this point, I was starting to get frustrated. And whenever that happens, I usually try to do things differently. And this time I thought I would eliminate something in my process instead of adding to it. And so I thought, okay, I'll do another sketch, but this time around, I'll go straight at it with a paintbrush. No more underdrawings. And so this little square here actually started off just a white blank space. And that forced me to focus on the photo reference and pay close attention to the color contrast and the different tones. And the end result is actually pretty good. A lot better than the other two, which is this one and this one. So the middle one was the last one that I did, and it came out the best because it's the one with the right colors, the right balance of tonal contrast, and it had the least amount of details. And so having observed that, I thought I would apply the same approach over here. Now, you'll notice that in the beginning I was quite conservative about it. Similar to how I approach my Sunday sketches, I would do monochrome paintings, so just one color, and then gradually I would add in a second color, and then in the last two panels, this is where I added more colors. Now I realized that these paintings are illustrations of calm waters with a few ripples in them. I have yet to do a few more exercises with more turbulent water, but this is a good exercise to rebuild my confidence in my ability to paint. So I expect to do a few more exercises on the side, but in the next video, we'll start to color some characters characters that I've designed so that I will have a mock-up of how my characters will look in their environment using the colors that I've selected.